Everyone, welcome back to my channel. So if you are new here, I'm Ellie and I run friendly interiors, plenty of home hauls, interior styling, and obviously as you know I am a merchandiser. For anyone who loves to shop will know exactly where I'm based, and I am lucky enough to work here. Although I would like to add before I do this video that no way, shape or form is this sponsored, advertised or endorsed by Homesense. This is all from my free time. I just want to do boss videos for you and help you learn how to style in your home. I am sorry if you can hear the music, there's nothing I can do about that. Obviously, as you know, I am in a store environment and it is 7 o'clock, so I am a bit tired, but I really just want to create this content for you. So I want to give you these amazing styling videos. You know, everyone asks me all the time, how do I incorporate this? How do I do this, that and the other? And I just want to show you and be able to walk through it. Like, if you do follow me over on Instagram, plugging it here, I do actually post a lot of my merchandise, and that I am lucky enough to do as my job. And create these amazing furnitures, and I do get asked a lot of time how I do it, what I do and things like that. So this is not going to be a merchy video. It's going to be more so how you can take items from a shop and take them home, and you're not paying top price. You're just building your collection up, and I know everyone loves this shop, so I don't really need to promote it, to be honest with you. Not that I am, because as I say, this isn't a promotional video. I just want to create amazing content for you. So, and I doubt a hugely successful company like Homesense is going to be bothered about little Ellie. Hey there. Whilst everyone's getting the shop ready for customers. So today I am going to be doing a tribal look. I won't be telling you the prices of things or not, but I just want to give you an incentive and an idea on how to do that. So tribal is going to be very autumn winter this year. It's very loud colours. I also want to help you build your confidence with using colours. Like, when I first started this job, was very grey and white. Now my house is very grey and white. I wasn't very confident with colours, but since starting this job and I've had that time to be creative, I've actually grew in confidence. So if you're someone who loves colour, it's just about going for it and learning how to work them together, which I'm going to show you today. I'm so excited to do this series, you know, it's just going to be amazing. So without further ado, let's begin. So as you can see behind me, it is a grey sofa. Now, I think everyone, or most people I know, especially from Liverpool, have a grey couch. The reason I'm using a grey sofa is because I don't want to really do this look as if you have to pay out things that you don't need. So I'm going to use this grey sofa in my analogy of this styling. Now, if you've got a brown sofa, a green sofa, whichever colour you've got, you just work with that. But I think this grey sofa is quite a popular choice. It's quite soft, it's quite dull looking at the moment. Show you how you can incorporate the tribal theme literally using your basic grey sofa, and we're just going to build up pieces, and I'm going to talk you through how I'm doing it, why I'm using things and what I'm choosing and things like that. So I have Ollie of Goods. Let me go get that. My trolley of goods. I've literally been around the shop. So the planning that's gone into this video, by the way, can we just add clipboard folder? For anyone wants to know, some paper chain, because clearly I'm too lazy to take the label off. I was literally up all night planning this. Went around the store last night, taking photos of everything that I wanted to use. And I put an Instagram story on last night, and I was like, I'm not posting the things I've seen because I don't want anyone to buy them before I shoot this video. Because obviously they're still about in the store, so if everyone would have bought everything I wanted to use today, it would just be in tough luck, do you know what I mean? So yeah. Anyway, I'm just mumbling, like, we need to get into this video. So when choosing your theme and deciding on it, I tend to find one product that I'm obsessed with and that I want to base the look off. Most of the time people do this, because they find that one thing and they're like, oh my god, I love that cushion, I love that curtain, I love that throw, and I want to mix it all together and make a scheme from it. So for me, I spotted this cushion. How gorgeous is this cushion? And I thought, yes, this is giving me major tribal / Glastonbury vibes. Is that not just like Glastonbury written all over it? Like, I could see this in a teepee. So I've decided to pick this as my focal point. A focal point is a real big key concept in a design. It catches the eye of the audience, which is obviously people who will be coming to your home. And you know what, when someone says, oh my god, I love that, where'd you get it from? That's tend to be what your focal point piece will always be. I mean, to be fair, if you've got everything from Homesense, then Do you know what I mean? Everything is a focal point. But this also keeps the attention of the scheme. So once your eye is drawn to that and you pick up all the other pieces in your peripheral vision, you are literally just taking every ounce of colour, especially from this theme, in. So I decided to go for these. So with this cushion as well, when you are purchasing and you're shopping for your theme, make sure you're looking at which colours you've got. Like, using colour, you have just got an array of colours here to work with. Like, you've got just one, which is really, really good. Colour sometimes is more beneficial for that rather than sticking with your grey and white, because it's hard to pick them tones and mix and match it in your home. So although people say grey and white is boring, it is a lot harder actually to design with grey and white, because it's very much the same palette as with this. It's just got, look, you've got pinks, you've got blues, you've got everything, and this cushion just worked on so many levels for me. Like, I just thought, that is gorgeous. So instantly when I put this on that couch, just looks so much bigger and brighter. So if you do have a grey couch and you want them to add more colour, literally just throw a cushion on there, like, you'll be surprised. So I'll show you. Why does it look that gorgeous already? I've literally just put one on. But can you see what I mean? Like, it just looks better and brighter already. As you all know, with my merch, I do tend to do the two cushion design. Oh god, I'm falling over. I'm literally sitting, I'm literally sitting on the floor slash crouching literally to do this video. The struggle is real, but it's worth it. So yeah, if you follow me on Instagram. Wow, I'm plugging myself again. Shock. Yeah, so with my merch, I tend to do my cushions arrangements two and make them symmetrical. You can do your cushion formation in so many different ways, but I'm just going to show you how I personally do arrange my cushions. Now you might think that looks gorge, and it does, but texture in this design is key. So the tribal things, we're wanting to build elements up, we're wanting to create comfort and character. So any design that you do, you want to make sure it's comfortable for you. So I know a lot of people love cushions, but is it easy accessible? Like, do you want to be lugging your cushions off every night? I mean, I think fellas are sick of the girls. I know mine is. Taking all them millions of cushions that you've got on your bed off before you can actually get in. So it literally takes you 10 minutes to go to bed. What if you've got guests? Think about the comfort that it's adding. Are they going to be squished by all the cushions? Is it going to be comfortable for them? Sure that it's got character. So these cushions are major character builders within a scheme. When doing cushions, I think that does look nice, but I want it to be textured. I want it to be a vibe. So I tend to do another cushion behind them just to add that depth that I'm wanting. So for me, I have selected this cushion. Now this is still encompassing the tribal theme. It's got a gorgeous mustardy green tone. Again, I'm looking at my cushion. I've got gorgeous mustard and green tones within my cushion. So I've decided to pick this one. Now for me, I think it's too much clash with pattern, this side. However, if I got bored of them, these are a great cushion to purchase, because I could always get rid of them and mix up the style. So this is a gorgeous pattern on the front, by the way, but I'm actually going to use the back today. It's a gorgeous colour, and I do love a good old chop. If you haven't seen my Homesense haul, everyone knows that I'm loving the chop pillow. With a rectangular pillow, you can't really do the chop as well, and you don't get that same full effect. So I'm going to use this one. Both these cushions as well that I forgot to add is tassels. So with the tribal theme, it's actually so much texture as well as colour. I mean, some people like to go for more of a muted palette with tribal, but I think go big or go home. Like, if you're doing tribal, you've got to, this is all or not, and you can't just go half-hearted. And that's the thing with colour and design, you need to go for it. You need to just go for it. Like, that is just the be all and end all. So that's why I'm just showing you today why I think you should, and you can see like the before and afters of it as well. So yeah, as I said, the tassels are gorge. I'm going to be incorporating that throughout the design as well with other elements, but it's just gorge. Right, so let me chop these. Oh, come on. How much texture, excitement, depth is that added to this sofa? Like, honest to god, if you're someone who is afraid of colour, texture or style, I've literally used a grey sofa. Like, you can literally use any sofa you want, and look how changed it looks already. Like, can you imagine a gorgeous gold mirror across the back wall? I'm sure you've all got that boring sofa. You might have got it from a sofa shop years ago and you're like, how can I make this beautiful and brighter? That could be your finishing stop. That could be literally all you want to do. Add them gorgeous bright cushions, and here they are. Now I think they're a perfect match to go for. Now a lot of people say to me, can I use different shapes and sizes of cushions together? Cushion. So I personally would go for a square one at the back that you're chopping. Get something about the cushion though. So here I've gone for tassels. There is tassels on the bottom of that cushion as well, so it does actually mix and match in both of the tassel shades. So you want a cushion with character that is at the back. If your cushion at the front is plain, then you want a patterned cushion at the back. And if your cushion at the front is patterned, I tend to go for a plain cushion at the back. You don't want it to look cluttered, although you do want that texture and design. You don't want it to be overpowering, because it just literally can ruin the design. Instantly. Are doing a full room concept using a tribal theme. You've started off at grey sofa, you've picked your gorgeous cushions that you want. That is personally where I would start off with the cushions, but everyone's different. Just for this particular scheme, I spotted them and that's what fucked up my design, so it is each to their own. So from this scheme, I think what chairs would go gorgeous with this? I personally think the mustard cushions at the back work so well with this scheme. There's also orange tones in the cushion, if you can see them there. So I think an orange mustardy chair would look gorgeous. And funny enough, I have one right here. This is a gorgeous chair. It's so comfy, the texture on it is fab, and it just complements the scheme so, so well. So I'm just going to put it in front of it. It's a bit more orange tones than actually mustard. In this lighter cushion there, the X's that are in it is actually the same exact tone. So when I was actually product searching for this design, and this is something you can do when you actually do shop for your homeware, is take the cushion with you. So I had my cushion with me at all times. I was matching it with rugs, chairs, accessories. I had that with me at all times. If you're going to shops, don't be afraid to take your wallpaper sample, don't be afraid to take your curtains, your cushion, anything. Like, especially in here, we're so helpful. Like, if you've made it to a room visit, like I know I am, like, I love to know what people are designing in their homes, and I'm happy to help. Like, you know, just put it next to everything. Like, at the end of the day, you're buying what you want for your home, and I wouldn't care what anyone thought of me, to be honest with you. I'd be like that in the shop. So yeah, I think this looks gorgeous with the scheme. So if you are taking this design home, yeah, and you know, if you are taking notes, which I hope you all are, I hope you've all got your notepad and pen. I feel like I should have said that at the beginning. I think these are gorgeous. So you could have this sofa at the back, as I said, with a mirror, and then you could have two of these little chairs in a nook with some side tables. Would look gorgeous. Obviously, if this chair is in the opposite side of the room, you can use your cushions and take any colour that you want from it to implement the chair you're using. For me now, I'm not personally going to put a cushion on this, only because it does look cluttered and it doesn't look stylish, and that's not what I'm trying to go for on this particular video. But obviously, if that is in the opposite side of your room, you could use complementary cushions. I've got examples here, complementary cushion on this chair. Now, obviously, as I said, I personally, and I'm not, I've just literally threw that. So for the purpose of this, as I say, I'm not going to put it on because it just looks cluttered in such a small space. But obviously, if you're in the opposite corner of your house, it's completely different. It will look gorgeous. I'm also a big fan of these. I was actually torn between these and them, but they just have a bit more sun about them. But they are still gorgeous. They've got like the braided textured effect on them, and they are fab. But every cushion's fab, and so it was really hard to choose. So next up, I want to select my rug. Now, I think Aztec design with tribal is beautiful. So I have gone for this. How gorgeous is that? Now, obviously, I've been picking the mustard tones from the cushion I selected, and then I wanted to break it up by selecting more of a blue colour palette. So I think these are gorgeous. Attention to detail in this collection of rugs is fab. Like, there were so many to choose from. I was really spoiled for choice, to be honest with you. So I'm just going to lay this out now. Building your product, you don't want to rush it. Remember that styling is actually a journey, so there is going to be trial and error. Like, I was taking photos in of all the products, and then I was walking around with the cookie, and like I was picking different products. Like, this is all came about in 5 minutes. It's literally like the different products, looking at the colour tones, looking at what elements are going to work together. So don't feel rushed and feel like, oh, it's already done now. Like, it hasn't. Like, build your product, make that design work for you, and just make it look gorgeous. Baskets are stunning. I think that they complement any design. They can be used in the corner of a room, they can be used as a couch for storage, they can be used to hold your blankets, which I'm going to show you now. So for me, I have gone for this gorgeous wicker basket. It's also got a tassel. See the way, like, from that design, I have used a texture and used an element of tassel, and I've spread out and portrayed like the whole scheme. It makes the design coherent when you select something with an element and use it throughout the scheme. So here I've got tassels on here. There's actually tassels on mat that I've chosen, and there's also a cute little tassel here, and I think this is gorgeous. When styling and accessorising and you're using a colourful scheme like this, I tend to think golds and woods and wickers look so much better than anything else, and that is why I've selected a muted wicker basket. Obviously it's got the white in, which is still gorgeous, and this fab tassel, so I'm just going to pop it here. What do you think? That's gorgeous. Isn't that gorgeous? So I've got a wicker basket in my room, in my living room. I'm going to want it to hold blankets because, as I said at the beginning, comfort is key to any design. Obviously you want it to have character, but comfort, you know, you've got your cushions, you want people to fall into them, you've got your throw, you want people to feel like they can come and sit down and wrap up in it. So I have selected a mustard throw. Obviously mustard cushions, mustard chair that I'm dodging. So I decided to go for this. Now, a lot of people ask me, what is the trick to folding a throw? Putting on your sofa, the trick to styling a throw is actually getting it at its widest point, which is here, and doing like a ruffled effect like so, and having the rest hanging. We talk about the fact that it's got tassels on. Do you see what I'm saying? Yeah, so it would fall like a waterfall, so you would ruffle them all together at the top, have it hanging so it's like clumped at one end and obviously falls nicely onto the sofa. There's a dog outside. Can you believe people walk their dogs at like, I mean, now it's 8 o'clock, but like people walk their dogs at 8 o'clock in the morning. Like, I don't have a dog, but I would definitely not be a retail dog at 8 o'clock in the morning walking my dog, let me tell you. So anyway, that is the way you can do it on a sofa. You could actually fold it as well and put it more like structured. It's entirely up to you, but I think the waterfall looks great. I'm not going to have it on the sofa for this scheme. I'm actually going to have it in the basket because, as I say, when guests come, you want a basket full of throws, and then you should have one hanging out as well, just for that added design element. So next up, more accessories. You want a lovely comfy stool for your feet whilst you are sitting at your fabulous new mustard chair. So I have gone for a gorgeous wooden stool. Now I think these are fab. As you can see, more colour. If you are scared of colour, then don't be, because how much does this scheme work? Like, you should never be afraid of colour, and as I say, try whatever is key with colour. So this is actually lots of pinks, reds, maroons. There's literally so much going on in this stool, and that is why I love it, to be honest with you. It is actually contrasting against what I've already used, but it's also blending it in well as well. So I personally would put this under my chair. You could also put it next to your I have brought the stool over to sit on because my knees were a bit. So let's talk accessories. One of my favourite things when designing is the finishing touches. Now, if you're going for this scheme, you might think, oh my god, I'm just going to go all out and go for more colourful accessories. Well, not necessarily. There's so much powerful colour within the actual scheme that I want a kind of stylish and luxurious looking. So I've picked up a few of my favourite accessories here, which I think would be perfect in this scheme. So first off, lanterns. Lanterns are gorgeous. You could literally put a lantern in any room and it will just spice it up. So I don't know whether you follow a lot of people on Instagram, but they tend to, and I'm guilty for it, a lantern, use a lantern just to actually make the scheme look more inviting and finish off. So here I've used this gorgeous leather lantern. See the way it's quite stringy. When using a tribal theme, brown leathers, woods, golds, all that sort of stuff is perfect for this scheme. Oh my god, I thought that wasn't recording then. I was gonna flip. Yeah, these are gorgeous. Put lights in them. Something I love to go for is I think the range and next home maybe have those flickery lights that you just put batteries in. So no need to keep refreshing candles. The flickery lights look and work gorgeous within these. I just think this is gorgeous. I also love these woven baskets. These are from Homesense, in case you're not aware, are from an amazing place. So we work closely with people in poor countries in Rwanda. I can't actually say the place that it is from, and people handcraft these baskets. If you're not aware of it, definitely go on the website. You will find an amazing read about the projects that we get involved with. So they actually write the name. On the basket when they make it, which I think is such a personalised touch. Now with these, I don't know whether you've seen it, but if not, I will pop a photo on. People do feature walls with these, so they have different ones all along the wall, behind the sofa, on top of the soul table, and you can make a fab wall feature with these. So I think these in a tribal scheme are just a must. Like, the amount of the collection that we have available is just insane. Like, definitely, if I had the opportunity to go for like a Glastonbury tribal themed room for my clients, I would definitely pick these. This one I've picked personally because it's got the beige outer edges, and it's quite close to the mustard. I don't know if you can tell there. It's a very close shade. And I love the blue as well. I just think it pops out. So I would definitely, as I say, do a feature wall with those. But I just think that personal touch, like, now that someone else has made it and the name's on it, it's just really lovely. So again, we've got lanterns. We've also got these gorgeous hurricane candle holders. They actually come off, so if you did want to use this for something else, maybe putting like a gemstone on it, maybe a sculpture, you could literally mix and match, which is really clever. As I say, I think gold, like Whitney being within the scheme here, you can see that the gold works so well in this scheme. I don't think silver would work as well personally. You know, I do love silver, but I feel like in this scheme, gold just take that bold, majestic look off that you actually are aiming for. Foliage faux plants, you just can't go wrong. So here I've got this plant. I'm not really good with plants, so I don't actually know what this one is called. I feel like it looks ferny. I might be wrong in saying that. But you could literally pick any plant that you want. You could get a tall plant, you could have a small plant. I'd personally put this on like a console or a styling unit that you do have, as it just adds texture, and you know I am a sugar for plants in a room. Plants do boost your mental health. Any biophilic design, whether it's fake or real, I have fake plants because there's absolutely no way that I could look after the real one. I have not the time for it. I hope this plant though doesn't take me out like my last video. My last plant that I had was ridiculous. I also think ceramics look gorgeous in a tribal theme. So this jug is fab. This is actually a decorative jug, not something that you can drink out of, I'm afraid. Ceramic pieces are gorgeous. Most of them do vary of colours. So again, I've gone for this blue tone. I wish I had a console table to start with, but for this, I am only doing like a room scheme. But if you do want to see a console table styled in different themes, let me know, because I know a lot of people have trouble actually styling a console. So I would incorporate pieces like this if you are going for a scheme like this. And finally, a sculpture. How gorgeous is this? Now, if this doesn't say tribal, I don't know what does. I think these are beautiful. Again, I will put these on a console table. The pieces I've used actually create proportion and scale within the scheme, and they don't take too much away from the big design. Remember going back to the original points that I made, I wanted my cushions to be the focal point. So by accessorizing, I don't want to take that focal point away from the original pieces that I've picked. So these are just complementary pieces that I'd be using on the console table. I just think this is gorgeous. I really want to buy them, but I actually need to stop buying things from here because, yeah, it's just actually a bad joke. Can you imagine the money I spend on here? It is ridiculous. So yeah, again, I would definitely put this on your console. It's all about creating balance and harmony within a room. You don't want to overpower it, you just want it to look luxurious. So I absolutely love, love, love this design. You know, as well, tribal goes really well with like a boho scheme. Now you might say, yeah, it is tribally, but it is quite boho. It is, but if you wanted to go for more of that boho look, it has a lot more linens and plants and concrete, like they would be like more of that kind of vibe. This is going for more of a colour pop and a colour wow. So this is the finished look. That's it, guys. This is the finished look. I hope that you've took some key points away. I hope you did get your notebook and your pen out. I have absolutely loved doing this video, so this is going to be a new series for me. I've got so many ideas, I've got so many videos coming, it's just going to be so, so amazing, and I'm working really hard to enable you to see how I work and how I style, and hopefully it will give you more confidence to use these types of colours in your home, because I don't want your house to be boring, I want it to be exciting, and I want people to go in and go, wow, I love your house, like, I love that piece, where did you get that? And these are just the perfect pieces to do that. So as I say, I hope that you have enjoyed it. I hope that you have took away some key tips, because that's what these videos are all about. I just want to help you and help you learn and anything else that you want out of these videos. So if you aren't already, please subscribe to my channel so I can keep these videos coming for you. Make sure you like this video as well, because it does mean the world. And as well, why not share it? Why not tell your friends? Why not say, oh, such and such, I believe you wanted to do a colourful scheme. Well, check out Fennel Interior's video. As I say, it would mean the world to me. And I've absolutely loved doing this video. I've really enjoyed it. Can't wait for you to see the next one. So obviously, I'm going to do a fab montage at the end to show you the scheme I've created. There will be photos over on my Instagram as well. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. I'm going to go and chill. I might go and grab myself a Costa. And yeah, I don't know what else, but thanks for watching.